Redis lists are a very flexible element. Using that, we can implement our stacks, which we can set just elements in the top, and always remove also from the top, and we also can implement queries. In which we can insert the elements in the top, but we remove elements from the bottom. It means the first element that was added was the first element that's going to be out. So with lists, we can implement a very flexible structure depending of your rules. And for that, we have a lot of operation that allow us to use push from left or push from right or pop from left or pop from right and some another operations to manipulate this structure. So let's explore the Redis lists and use some of these operations together. Here we have a Redis server running into a container, which we have set up in the last video in this channel. Then, now having that here available, we are going to handle lists. First thing you need to know is that the list is created automatically by using the operation that use the push elements in this list. So we create the list already adding element to that. So let's suppose we want to create here one list with the name heroes, setting this value here. We could, as you can see in the autocomplete suggestions, we can set a lot of elements together. In this case, we are going just with one element. What it returns? The current size of the list, one element. How we can check the elements there in the list? How we can read the elements? Different than another variables in Redis that we can use the get operator here, we cannot. We are using a list. Then we need to use operator like this one here, in which we have to say, I want to see elements from the position one onto the position, then you can set any position. In my case, I have just one element in the list. I could do like that. But if I set some value bigger, there is no problem. It will just show everything. Okay, it has just said my list is empty, probably because it starts with zero and not with one. So if you change that to zero, now we have one element named Wolverine. So okay, it's fine. Now let's add more elements here. We now could do again the same thing with LPUSH we have done in the beginning, but now adding two more elements. They are going to be added to the left. So now my list has three elements, one for the first push, and now two more in the second push. If we again ask for displaying our elements, we have now three elements here. Right, so we have a list with three elements. And what we can do now? Now we could decide to add elements, but in the another corner of this list. Have you seen the two elements I have added with LPUSH has been added here before the first one? But if I want to add elements here after the first one, like a query structure. So we can do this way with RPUSH, adding in the right, in the end corner of the list. Now I have five elements, three plus two. We can list all of them with LRANGE. And then here we have our elements listed. Right. And now we can explore how to remove these elements. We can do the operation LPOP just here, LPOP and the name of the list, heroes. Doing that, it's going to take out the elements from the left, that's Ruby. And now it was returned and removed. So this pop operation, remove the elements from the list and give it back to you. So as you can see here, this item is not more here. And we can do that any times before until the list is empty. We remove it from the first position because it's LPOP. If you want to remove from the last position, we should use RPOP and then the list name. And now storm was removed. And now our list has only 3 elements. There is one last operation I would like to show to you. That's how to verify the list size. That is the LEN, LLEN, length from length. And then here we just set the name of the list and it returns the current size of the list. So if that using these operations here we have presented, you are going to be able to handle the Redis list data structure. Thank you for watching.